Hello again, students, and welcome to my flipped classroom. Today, our work will be with brainstorming. Oh, your brain and a storm. And it's a how-to. So we'll be working in order to be able to 1. Learn why I should brainstorm. Also, learn how to brainstorm, so that eventually in the classroom, we can use brainstorming for project and writing assignments. That will be very helpful. So, the first part of today, we need to look at why should I brainstorm? What's the point? It's just more work, right? Well, no, actually brainstorming helps bring forth ideas, helps to make connections or connections between ideas and topics, helps to organize the thoughts, and also helps to create questions for research. It is a best practice. It is something we want to do. So, now your question is, all right, I know why, but how? Well, I'm going to give you 3 different methods for it. The first method is called the mind map. This is for mostly nonlinear thinkers. People who are non-linear thinkers don't like things like outlines or structure when they're thinking. So this is very perfect for you. The way that will work, you will put your main topic here in the middle bubble, and then fine, you will have little spider legs and little bubbles, and here's the main topic. You might have an idea. You will put it there, another idea, a question, another idea, and another bubble. So maybe you have a lot of information that you already know, but well, I have a lot of questions about what I know. So and you can make as many spider legs and as many bubbles as you want, and if you need more paper, we can do that for you too. The second method that we're going to explore today is the outline method. This is for you linear learners. You like things neat, in a line, logical progression, so the outline does it for you. You would label your topic up here, and then you will start with Roman numeral 1. That will be an idea. Then perhaps something you know. It will be A, goes under Roman numeral 1, something I know about, but B, perhaps a question I know about an idea. If you have another idea, you can put a 2, and perhaps you have a question about that. There is something I know. Oh, but I have a question about that, something I know. So you can put a little I here so that you can write that question, and you will continue until you run out of ideas. Okay, so what if you looked at all of this and you said, oh, I don't like either of them. I have a third method that you can use. It's called the ABC brainstorm. So you would write the alphabet, okay? And then you will also think about what's my topic? And I will think about, I know an idea that begins with an A. So I will write that idea or fact next to A. Maybe I know something within an E. So I will write that next to the E. Perhaps I know something with an O. I will write that next to O, and so on and so forth until you get as many letters as you can fill up. So yay, now we know several methods of how to brainstorm, and we know the why of brainstorming. So now let's allow the storms to begin. It's raining ideas, and I would like to see that. Don't forget to study at home, and I will see you in class. Bye-bye.